Honorable Mr. Justice Rishikesh Roy, Judge Supreme Court of India, respected Madam Mrs. Chandana Ashwini Roy, Honorable Mr. Justice Indrajit, Mr. Justice Alo, Judge High Court of Tripura, Honorable Mr. Justice S. Chattopadhyay, Judge High Court of Tripura, Shrimati Nilima Ghosh, Chairperson, State Commission for Protection of Child Rights, other dignitaries and invited guests of the dais, friends of the media, and my dear students from different parts of Tripura. As Member Secretary of Tripura State Legal Services Authority, I feel privileged to offer the welcome address in today's unique and also express our gratitude to His Lordship for gracing us with His inspiring presence and for kindly consenting to inaugurate today's program. My deep gratitude to His Lordship, Honorable Mr. Justice Hrishikesh Roy, and encouragement laid the foundation for today's program. Thank you, my Lord, for kindly consenting to preside over today's interactive session. I also would like to welcome Honorable Mr. Justice, my proud privilege to also welcome Honorable Mr. Justice L. Oth, Judge High Court of Tripura and Chairman High Court Legal Services Committee, and Honorable Mr. Justice S. Chattopadhyay, Judge High Court of Tripura. Thank you, my lords, for your friends from the media, district admission officers, teachers, parents, without whose supports, children could not have been able to attend this program. A special round of thanks is due to the Learned Registrar General, High Court of Tripura, as well as Chairman of Tripura District Legal Services Authority, Mrs. Aparajita Devarma, District Secretary District Legal Services Authority, West Tripura, Shri Hannah Magon, Deputy Secretary, Shasha, all the chairmen and secretaries of district and sub-divisional legal services, vision of equal justice and free legal. Significantly, NASA has launched Pan-India Awareness and Outreach Campaign from 2nd October to 14th November to coincide with the...
When the Honorable Chief Guest and the Honorable Guest of Honor arrived at Agartala, we received them. And I was in my mind thinking of what message can I pass on to 800 students, 800 students from 8 districts of Tripura and representing all the subdivisions of the proud state of Tripura. So first and foremost, I would like all you children to first of all raise the flag and say thank you to yourselves. Come on. Say thank you to yourselves. Come on, let's do it. You people have made today's event what it is. You people have made today's event what it is. And it is the spirit of what you have said, what you have sung, what you have said, and by your participation, you have inspired in me, though I have not yet been a month here, but you have inspired in me a desire to be known as a Tripuri. You are the pride of the nation. And only thing I wanted to share is, I read an article in the Times of India yesterday. It spoke about a little girl by the name of Vinisha Umashankar. She is a 15-year-old girl from the state of Tamil Nadu. She had gone to Glasgow as a child representative at the climate conference that was being held in Glasgow. You may have heard about it and read about it or watched it on television. But this 15-year-old girl who went to Glasgow to represent the children of India gave a speech in Glasgow. I'm sure I can speak of many things that may make sense or may not make sense, but I thought the biggest contribution I can make to today's conference and to you, my children, is merely read to you what Vinisha Umashankar, a 15-year-old girl from Tamil Nadu, said in her speech at COP26 in Glasgow. I'm reading it because it was reported in English, and I've requested the Registrar General to organize someone who I've asked it to be translated into Bengali. So I'll just read these three paragraphs. I'm reading and I'm quoting her. Just by the way, Vinisha Umashankar had gone to not only attend the conference, she was shortlisted for a prize known as Earth Short Prize, and she was a finalist. So I'm reading her speech to the world at Glasgow. We, the Earth Short Prize winners and finalists, are proof that the greatest challenge in the history of our Earth is also the greatest opportunity. The greatest challenge in the history of our Earth is also the greatest opportunity. We lead the greatest wave of innovation humanity has ever known. We lead the greatest wave of innovation humanity has ever known. We chose not to complain. We chose not to complain, but take actions that will make us healthier and wealthier. We chose to do these things not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Rising to these challenges will shape a new generation, a generation that will build a better world for all of us and generations to come. Now comes the main part of her speech. We won't wait for you to act. We won't wait for you to act. We will lead, even if you don't. Do you understand what she is saying? Who is she addressing? She's addressing the entire world. She's addressing the adult world. She's addressing the leaders of all the countries in the world. What does she say? We won't wait for you to act. We will lead even if you don't. We will build the future even if you are stuck in the past. We will build the future even if you are stuck in the past. And then the last line. Please accept my invite. I assure you, you won't regret it. As an individual standing here amongst you, I sent her an email yesterday telling her I have accepted her invite. I'll request somebody to read out the Bengali translation of it. Please.
These children who spoke here, they spoke their mind on three issues. Number one, first speaker spoke about the pressure and expectations of a child in today's world. And as Justice Mohanty said, the Honorable Chief Justice, those children themselves have now provided some kind of a solution. The second one said about the body insecurity. Now, these are all problems of children today. As a child, I also had these kind of, you know, negative feelings on certain issues, but then you start growing up, and as the learned speaker said, that we have to develop that confidence, we have to overcome those issues and be comfortable with what you are. And the third child spoke about secularism as an issue. These are all broader aspects, broader areas, which perhaps at this juncture in today's speech, we may not deliberate and delve into that. Coming to the basic ideas, which are essentially sort of to be touched upon today, are the rights of the children, to be better educated, to be given. And I had a word with one of the teachers here. I asked her whether, because some of the posters do say the offenses against the children, the exploitation of the children, that whether the children, the girls, are made aware of the POXO legislation. And we were told that yes, they are. So three or four things, and then I'll sum it up. Education, of course, yes. The health and well-being in every sense, no human trafficking, no child trafficking, no child abuse. Create an environment where, because in most of the child abuse cases, the perpetrator of the crime could be a member of the family or a respectable elder in the neighborhood, or the sphere of activity of the child could be a teacher, could be anybody. And therefore, the atmosphere must be developed where the child would be feeling completely confident that if he or she raises a voice, that voice will not go unheard. That voice will not only be heard, but corrective measures will immediately be taken. In that sphere, I'll just touch upon the last part, and that is, which is NALSA's concern, and we will be embarking on that particular line hereafter. That's not only just the child human trafficking, child abuse, but child pornography is also something which must be taken care of. I had an occasion as a judge to deal with a matter, and all these internet service providers, I asked them, can you not prohibit a particular offensive material to be aired or to be telecast? Their response was that we are not completely in control of our platform. Our platform is like a highway. Anybody can get in, anybody can get out. And therefore, there is inherent difficulty. We may download, we may sort of offload a content, reprehensible and offensive content, in about 72 hours. But one of the apprehensions which we expressed on the bench was that in those 72 hours, the reputation of a child or the victim may take such a beating that perhaps it may be irreversible. We want to have a statutory mechanism under which perhaps this can be remedied, and that will be the endeavor of NALSA in future. I'll tell you one instance, because this is how the platforms in US and certain other advanced countries are actually working under. A particular offensive material was uploaded through a laptop, and within 15 minutes, this happened in US, the man was apprehended. Why does it happen in those countries and does not happen in our country? The artificial intelligence which is employed and used by those service providers immediately picks up an offensive content and sends the red signal to the concerned police station saying that this is the number from which the content was uploaded. These are mechanisms, these are, today we are living in world of technology, that technology must be utilized for the best results possible and for the benefit of the society. So NALSA will certainly be working in that direction, and we will be coming out with some kind of modalities or a module in next few days to come. Now coming to the last part, this outreach program will culminate on 14th of November. That's the Children's Day. I stand here in front of 800 children coming from a remote corner of the country, but they represent true values, they represent correct posture. And I must say that going by what these children have presented today, the future of our generation is quite well secure. In environmental law, they speak about intergenerational equity. That is, whatever I have inherited from my parents when I hand it over to the next generation, I must hand over in a better format and form the earth. I am quite sure that the future of our future generations is quite well secure in the hands of these children. Thank you so much.